Hey everybody, Languages Lover here and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm here to answer a very important question that some of you guys have asked me through social network. If you had to pick like 10 other languages apart from the ones that you're currently learning or that you already speak, what would they be? So that's what I'm here to answer today. I'm gonna make a video about the 10 languages that I don't speak and I don't currently plan to study, but that if I ever decide to choose another 10 languages, I would probably pick these ones because they attract me. So I hope you guys will enjoy this video, but first, quick reminder, hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell icon to get notified for every new video that I upload to not miss a single new video, because I, throughout the summer, I'm gonna try to upload as much as I can. So I hope you'll enjoy, so please hit the subscribe button, you won't regret it. Alright, so let's start the video. At number 10, I would probably have Galician. Now, it's not a very important language, like, internationally wise, but the reason why I put Galician on the list is probably because first, it's a Romance language, and my mother tongue is a Romance language. So adding another Romance language to the group would probably not be a bad idea, because I would obviously already have some basics of the language. And I know some Galician, but not that much. But no, actually, I don't remember a single word of Galician, but the only thing I remember from it is that it's pretty much Portuguese, but with a Spanish accent. It is very, very similar to Portuguese, but you don't pronounce the words as you would probably in Portuguese. You pronounce them much more with a Spanish accent. I don't mean to offend anyone just by saying that, but it's just the impression I got. But and I read that from a book, so please don't judge me. But yeah, so Galician would probably be a good idea to actually study. And number 9, I would probably have Estonian. I know it's a weird choice probably, because if you know Finnish and Hungarian, Estonian is pretty similar. I don't believe it has as much cases as Finnish and Hungarian. Heck, no language has more cases than Hungarian. But the reason why I would probably learn Estonian is because I've always been interested in the language. I know some people from Estonia. I met them like a while back. I'm not sure I'm still in contact with them, but I will have to check. But yeah, and I always wanted to go to Estonia. From the pictures I've seen, it's pretty beautiful. So, and the language, whenever I hear it on like, you know those YouTube videos where you have to guess the language? Whenever it's Estonian, I was like, that's Estonian? Wow, that's beautiful. But anyways, that's probably why I would learn Estonian. At number 8, this is probably for work purposes, but I would probably pick Tagalog. The reason why I say I'd probably pick Tagalog next would probably be because during the summertime at my workplace, there are a lot of people from the Philippines. Heck, I believe it's one of the most common languages there, apart from French, obviously. And we also have a lot of Spanish speakers, obviously. And some Arabic and Portuguese, mostly. We did have one Romanian and one Chinese, but it's been a while, so. But they're not the most common. Spanish is hands down the most common one, but during the summer, Tagalog is probably the best one to choose, because there is a lot of people from the Philippines coming shopping, going shopping where I actually work, so that's probably why I would learn Tagalog. And number 7, another difficult language, I would probably have Icelandic. Yes, I know it's difficult, but I always love, I know it's kind of a weird reason, but you know, like the Icelandic names, like the capital, I'm not sure how to even pronounce that, Reykjavik or something like that. Apart from that, Icelandic is cool. Yeah, I heard there was cases, obviously, like Finnish, Hungarian, Russian, and, you know, all these nice languages that have cases. But And whenever I hear Icelandic, I know it's hard to pronounce words in Icelandic, but I'm gonna talk about a guy named that some of you may probably know called Daniel Tammet. He actually learned Icelandic in a week, and he's a native English speaker. But yeah, he's a savant, and he actually, before traveling to Iceland, he never actually spoken a word of Icelandic. But as soon as he found a teacher, he was able to speak it quite confidently. And at the end of the week, he actually went live on national television in Icelandic. He had an interview in Icelandic. And there's actually a documentary about him on YouTube, by the way. I believe it's called Daniel Tammet, A Language in a Week or something like that. But in the actual documentary, they actually show you near the end his trip with Icelandic, traveling to Iceland, learning with his tutor, and then going to the interview and coming out like victorious. So, and I also have an easier time learning languages, but yeah, I don't know if I would be able to learn as fast as Daniel Tammet, but I would probably try Icelandic, so yeah. Now for the other two, I don't have a lot of reasons for them, but yeah, they're pretty similar to as to why I want to learn them. Number six is Armenian. Now, the only two reasons I could find, though, I probably had it like lower on the list, but I actually know someone who speaks Armenian. So yeah, that has another layer to why I want to learn Armenian. And first off, beautiful script. I really like the script. I don't even know how to read that. But from what I know, Armenian is the only language that uses the script. And it's a very beautiful script. If you haven't seen it yet, please go ahead, look it up on Google or on any YouTube video probably. It's a very beautiful script, and yeah, and I've always wanted to go to Armenia as well. I love the architecture there, and I would like to meet a lot of people that speak Armenian to actually practice with them. And the language that has similar reasons to why I want to learn it is probably Georgian. The script, I really like the script. It looks kind of complex at first, because it's like, I really don't know how to write Georgian, but it's like circles, and you do stuff like this, or yeah. But like I said, don't judge me. I've never studied Georgian, but I would really like to study Georgian because the script is very beautiful. And I know that one of my friends and another one of my polyglot friends, which is, if you love languageless videos, you probably know him, which is Richard Simcott. I saw one of his interviews on YouTube with the gang from Italki, and he actually said that the main reason why he actually started to learn Georgian is because he was attracted to the script. And I feel him. I really feel him. Because I really like how Georgian looks. The script, yeah, the script. From what I heard, it also sounds beautiful, but the grammar is, it's difficult. So, but yeah. All right, now moving on to number four, which is a language that I never thought I might be interested in learning, but now that I actually decided to make this video, I was like, that one would be nice. And it is Swahili. Now, Swahili is one of the languages that's unique to Africa. It's not a major language outside of Africa. You're not gonna find it in America, Europe, Asia, or heck, Oceania. But I've always been interested in Africa, and the fact that I don't have a major language that's unique to Africa in my language list kind of makes me feel bad. So I would probably learn Swahili, because I do know a lot of people that speak Swahili, and heck, they are Africans, so they could actually teach me their language, because I would really like to learn Swahili and actually go to Africa. I've never been to Africa, actually, as a lot of you probably know, but I would really like to go on a safari, because I really like animals, and yeah, that's probably why I would learn Swahili. At number three, the same for Georgian and Armenian, the two next languages have very similar reasons as to why I actually want to learn them. At number three, I have Urdu. Yeah, a language with the Arabic script, which is very difficult for foreigners to learn. But there's a plus side of that. Urdu is actually mutually intelligible with Hindi, which is a language that I already speak and am currently studying. So if I were to pick up Urdu, it wouldn't be that bad, which I have to go through the script, but India and Urdu have different scripts as well. So it's fairly funny that they are mutually intelligible when they have a different script. But Urdu, outside of that, is actually one of the world's most widely spoken languages. I believe last time I saw it was around, Hindi or maybe Arabic, but I'm not sure about that. I'll have to relook it up. But yeah, Urdu, I do know for a fact, is one of the world's most widely spoken languages, and it's probably one of the languages that would probably be good to study. All right, number two, another language that's mutually intelligible with one that I'm learning is Indonesian. Indonesian is mutually intelligible with Malay, because heck, they're spoken in around the same spot. They're spoken in Southeast Asia. And same with Hindi and Urdu. India and Pakistan are like right next to each other, so I don't know if this has anything to do with the fact that they're mutually intelligible, because Hindi and Urdu, alongside Indonesian and Malay, are the only languages that are mutually intelligible to another language that I know of. If there are any other, please let me know. I would be very happy to read your comments. But hey, Indonesian, apart from the fact that it's mutually intelligible with Malay, I would also like to go to Indonesia. I like the landscape there, very beautiful. And also know a guy that does Indonesian videos on YouTube, and he's my friend, so I would like to support him if I actually decided to learn Indonesian, so yeah. And now, the last language I would probably learn, or my number one language I would probably learn, is another African language, and it is Afrikaans. Afrikaans? Well, I would probably learn Afrikaans next is because, first off, just like I said in one of my last videos, I have a book about a comparative grammar of Spanish, Portuguese, Italian, and French. The author of that book, which I said I would probably do an interview with him this summer about the book, is actually writing another book right now, which is the same but for Germanic languages, and Afrikaans is a Germanic language. If I saw correctly by screenshots, I'm not sure if that's confirmed, but I think it's gonna be about English, German, Dutch, and Afrikaans. And since Afrikaans is the only language in the book that I currently don't speak, it would be a good choice. And just because of the fact that Afrikaans is like 99% or 95, at least 90% similar with Dutch and English, their sister languages, and it has also some similarities to German. So speaking these three languages, English, Dutch, and German already, wouldn't make it a very hard language to learn. So that's probably why I would learn Afrikaans. So that was my list, guys. I hope you enjoyed, and if you have, give it a big thumbs up. Subscribe, that'd be super awesome, amazing, and I'll see you next time. Bye.